Since lane width is a function of frequency, we can get the additional area simply by changing the frequency. This is precisely the way the Omega system resolves lane ambiguity, by having the stations transmit at frequencies of 13.6 kilohertz and 11 and 1/3 kilohertz, as well as their basic frequency of 10.2 kilohertz. The additional frequencies are transmitted during the same time interval of 10 seconds, but the format is arranged so that no two stations are transmitting on the same frequency simultaneously. These particular frequencies were selected because of the relationship between them. For example, the frequency 13.6 kilohertz yields a lane width of 6 miles, so that 4 13.6 kilohertz lanes equal exactly 3 of the 8-mile 10.2 kilohertz lanes. By itself, the 13.6 kilohertz transmission doesn't help resolve ambiguities because it produces smaller lanes. In order to increase lane width, we need a lower frequency, which we obtain by having the receiver electronically take the difference between the 10.2 and the 13.6 signals, giving us a much lower frequency of 3.4 kilohertz and a lane width of 24 miles. This new lane helps resolve lane ambiguity because now we have a lane 3 times as large in which to place ourselves. And instead of being required to know our position within plus or minus 4 nautical miles, we now have a radius of 12 miles in which to establish lane count. Here's the way it works. By dead reckoning or other navigational means, we can establish our rough position within one of the 24-mile lanes. Then, a percent of lane reading immediately tells us in which part of the large lane the ship is located. Since the 24-mile lane corresponds to 3 8-mile lanes, knowing the percent of lane enables us to place the ship in one of the 8-mile lanes, and we can reset or reinitialize the receiver accordingly and resume automatic tracking. Using the same procedure with the 11 and 1/3 kilohertz signal and the 10.2 kilohertz signal, we get a difference of 1.1 and 1/3 kilohertz with still wider lanes of 72 miles, which in turn give us a much larger margin for ambiguity. And using the same procedure, we can work our way down to a 24-mile lane and ultimately to an 8-mile lane. In spite of the availability of the other two frequencies, the 10.2 kilohertz signal is the essential frequency needed for accurate navigation. The additional signals simply make it possible for suitably equipped receivers, with the aid of dead reckoning, to resolve lane ambiguity anytime and anywhere on the globe. After the receiver readings have been taken, the Omega SkyWave correction tables must be used to take into account changes in the ionosphere at different locations, different times of the month and day, and the effect these conditions have on transmission.